हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ स्नेहल कड़भाने। वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑन फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस। इन दिस सेशन मेनली थ्री पॉइंट्स विल बी कवर्ड। फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस। सेकंड, व्हाई टू स्टडी फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस। थर्ड, वेयर इज द एप्लीकेशन फॉर फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस। वी विल स्टार्ट विद द वेरी फर्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज व्हाट इज फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस। Finite element analysis in a short form is termed as a FEM. So what is FEM? On this same slide you can observe four diagrams. First two images stands for the bus, third stands for some rotor on which blades are mounted, and fourth stands for the aeroplane. In all these diagrams, what is similarity? Just by looking at the diagram we can observe some contour plots are plotted. You can observe various colors, somewhere red, then green, blue, yellow, various colors are there. So what is meant by FEM? See, finite element analysis, this entire title is actually splitted into three small segments. It consists of three main words, and that is finite, then element, and then analysis. So in FEA, actually we make the analysis of elements which are finite. Its simple meaning is that in FEA, irrespective of which type of analysis we are going to perform, but during analysis we consider elements of a finite size, and we do not perform analysis over the infinite size element. So in case of FEA, very important step is that whenever we have to analyze any object, that object may be a bus, it may be an aeroplane, it may be a railway, it may be a table, it may be a chair, or it may be a human body. Whenever we have to make its analysis, that time during performing analysis over that body, that entire body should be discretized into very small number of elements. So that is the very first main important step. And as during analysis finite elements are considered, this analysis is termed as a finite element analysis. And a dividing entire body into small number of segment is known as a discretization, which is the very important step of FEM. In case of FEA, which type of analysis we can perform? We can perform various types of analysis: structural analysis, static analysis, modal analysis, thermal analysis, electromagnetic, then you see every fluent, that is the flow analysis, dynamic analysis. In FEA, we can perform various types of analysis. But first of all, what is meaning of analysis? See, analysis means prediction of behavior of a body. Whenever we will apply some external force on a body, then after application of that external force, how body will behave or how body will respond. Studying that prediction of behavior of that body is known as an analysis. For example, let us consider, I will just give you example of table, that we are having one table, and now I have to put one computer on that table. So that computer is nothing but the load applied on that table. So after putting computer on a table, what will happen to table? And now if a elephant will stand over the table, what will happen to table? So this prediction of what will happen to table is known as the analysis. This was example of structural analysis. Similarly, we can perform thermal analysis, flow analysis, magnetic analysis, anything. So analysis purely means after application of external force, how a particular body will behave, whether it will still remain at its position, whether it will start moving, whether it will lead to failure. For example, if elephant will stand over the table, then again depending upon how much is weight of elephant, whether still table will be at its position, it will get broken down, it will get moved from its position, or it will lead to its complete failure. Likewise, this is known as an analysis. And in FEA, we can perform different types of analysis. Second main point, why to use FEM, that is finite element method. For analysis, there are various methods. Out of that, FEA is one of the method. So question arises, why to use FEM? First of all, again, see, whenever we have to solve any engineering problem, for example, aeroplane is going to travel and through the sky, and if we want to predict that how much or how many and where thermal stresses will be developed in the body of aeroplane. So how to solve this engineering problem, that how many and where thermal stresses are developed. See, to solve any engineering problem, there are three approaches: mathematical approach, analytical, experimental approach, and then third one is the numerical approach. If geometry and size of a body of which analysis is to be done, if its size is within the limit, dimensions are within the limit, and geometry is also specific, regular, for example, triangular, rectangular, circular, pentagon, hexagon. See, for such type of geometry, that is rectangle, circle, triangle, we know the basic mathematical formula. For example, if we want to calculate area of a table, or if we want to calculate stress developed into the table after application of load, in that case, we don't even need any experimental method, or even we don't need any simulating method, because size of table is always within the limit, 6 feet by 6 feet, maximum 20 feet by 25 feet, likewise. And also, there is a specific rectangular geometry available for the table. And in our mathematics, there are formulas to calculate area, volume, load for the specific regular geometry such as rectangle, triangle, and circle. But what if same we have to calculate for the bodies like metro, aeroplane? See, in case of aeroplane, metro, or for a ship, or for the flyover bridge, if we want to calculate now stresses developed into the flyover bridge, how come it is possible that we can calculate stresses developed into the flyover bridge? See, it is not possible to calculate directly, because first of all, that flyover bridge does not have uniform geometry. Second thing is, its dimensions are too bigger. That's why whenever we perform, first of all, we need to divide entire bridge into small number of segments. After that, we have to apply our mathematical formulae to each that segments, divided segment. After that, we have to predict behavior for a smaller segment, and after that, we have to combine result of all segments, and then we can predict the result. And this is known as the FEM, where that whenever we are having complex geometry and when dimensions are too bigger, in that case we divide entire body into small number of elements and we predict the behavior of each segment, and after that we combine the result of the total body. So answer to the question that why finite element method is that whenever we have complex geometry and also when their dimensions are too much bigger, in that case we can't go for analytical method, as we don't have a direct mathematical formula to find out the to calculate area of an aeroplane, volume of an aeroplane. Similarly for a ship, because there is no uniform geometry, so in that case we need to go for some another numerical method, and option to that is nothing but FEA, as FEA is one of the numerical methods. at the end I will say that to analyze complex geometry we need finite element method or any another simulation method. Third main point, where are the applications for FEA, that is finite element analysis? FEA finds application everywhere, in mechanical, in aerospace, in civil engineering, in automobile engineering, everywhere. It performs various types of analysis. If it is structural analysis, again in structural we can perform static, dynamic, linear or non-linear. And for example, if we want to analyze trusses, beam, framework, machine parts, structures, again in thermal analysis, if we want to analyze nuclear pressure vessel, nuclear reactor, everything can be analyzed by using FEM. Also, if we want to analyze crankshaft, cam, linkages, gear, bone, teeth, load carrying capacity of implant and prosthetic system. So, in stress analysis, again in analyzing casting, forming, welding, that is nothing but the manufacturing sector. Again, to analyze the flow, boundary layer flow, viscous flow, free surface flow, potential flow. So, all types of analysis can be performed by using FEA. So, wherever there is a scope to analyze something, there is application for FEA. In our engineering, there are mainly three methodology to solve any engineering problem, as just I discussed before. And those three methodologies are analytical, numerical and experimental. Analytical method means if we know, for example, we know the radius of circle and we are asked to calculate the area of a circle and or to find out volume of a circle, there are direct mathematical formula that is known as the analytical approach. But see, there is no direct formula to calculate area of a ship, volume of a ship. Then second is experimental method. For example, I have one heat exchanger. A constant heat flux condition is provided on a surface of a heat exchanger. Water flows through heat exchanger. And now we are supposed to find out temperature at a regular interval on a surface of a heat exchanger. So that is known as experimental. We have to install thermocouples on a surface and at a particular interval, after 5 cm, 10 cm, 15 cm, we can measure the temperature. Now what is numerical method? As just now we discussed, whenever we have complex geometry, then to make structural, thermal, magnetic, any kind of analysis, we need some another method, and these methods are nothing but the numerical method. What is main difference between analytical, numerical and experimental? Analytical is a classical approach, numerical is a mathematical approach, experimental is at actual measurement. That's why analytical provides 100% accurate result. Even in case of experimental, we can take one by one more trial and we can reach up to the accurate result. While in case of numerical method, it is completely based on the predictions, assumption. Because of that, what happens? Our answer is never accurate, rather it is approximate or converged toward the exact answer. We can't say numerical method gives wrong answer. It gives answer which is closer to the exact answer. That's why numerical methods are known to provide approximate answer, and they are the approximate approach to find out the solution. So analytical is classical approach, experimental is at actual approach, while numerical methods are the approximate, and FEA, FDM, they all fall under the numerical method. Different numerical methods are FEM, finite element method, boundary element method, and third is finite difference. First question, is it possible to use all above listed method, that is finite element, beam element, FEM is finite volume method, FDM is finite difference method. Can we use this all to solve the same problem? Answer is yes, we can use any of them to solve the same problem, but difference will be in the accuracy achieved. next question, are FEA and FEM different? No. Finite element analysis and finite element method, FEA and FEM, both are same. Only difference is that FEA is more popular in industry, while FEM term is popular at education level. Both are skill.